Welcome to On the Move, show number 360. We have come full circle to 360 degrees, still pointed true north, thanks in large part to our first and ever erstwhile director, Richard Martinez. Today we want to shout out, this is your life, Richard Martinez, for he's directed almost every one of the On the Move shows for the past 25 years. What an amazing accomplishment. Who persevered through rain and sleet, heart attacks, bypasses, leg surgeries, always showing up to be our director extraordinaire for 360 shows. Rich is moving on to other adventures, so this thank you and farewell show will be one of the few times that Rich will not be in control of all the goings-on in the studio for our On the Move show. Our host Donna Yeager will toast and roast and reminisce with Rich about the events that started this long run of volunteerism and dedication to our shows, raising awareness for the disabled community, their families, and their friends. Perhaps some unexpected guests will pop in to say a few words as well. Now our On the Move host, Donna Yeager, will pay a royal tribute to our director of 25 years, Rich Martinez.
Hi, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move, and I'd like to welcome our very special guests, Ed Edgerton. Welcome, Ed.
Thank you.
And LaVonne Hand.
Thank welcome, you, Donna. LaVonne.
And Rich Martinez.
Welcome, Rich.
How do you do, Donna?
Well, I wanted to start off by saying that my dream of starting On the Move really began quite a few years ago, and it's all of my college buddies and, you know, through encouragement of all of my friends, we really, you know, got the ideas together and talked to the Elliot Margulies over at the studio, and it was so important to, you know, get a crew together, and we just, you know, knew that that was going to be the thing that really helped to do the whole show. So, and my friend Jeff Braille at HP knew Rich Martinez, and we knew that he was our guy. So he didn't know it at the time.
But yeah.
So we kind of begged and pleaded. And
those were fun days, those early
yeah,
days.
They were,
I remember when we used to have... We used to do two shows a month in the beginning, if you remember.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And every Wednesday, we'd either be doing a show or we'd be meeting at the Yeagers to discuss the show that we were going to be doing next the following week.
Right.
And we used to have some great discussions and some heated discussions.
Right.
But we mashed it out, you know. We never missed a show. We got them all done.
Right.
Then we'd meet at a bar afterwards and discuss our mistakes.
You remember those days?
I remember those days.
That's right. We go out after a show and have a beer and critique the show.
Exactly. But actually, it was because of all of our friends, both at De Anza College and a lot of my high school friends, and as we got more a larger crew together, really we were able to, you know, ask other friends, and you know, we've had so many wonderful people through the years, and
it's a hall of fame of names. I mean, you know, Ed, LaVonne, Roxanne, Tim.
Right.
I mean, the list just goes on and on up to this current generation with Gordon and Tom and Gary and David and Ron and Joan. It's just, you know, an incredible group of people that we had to work with.
Exactly. And there were a lot of people also that really wanted to be here tonight as well, like Jerry LaBonville, and he worked very hard on the show, and Valerie Miller, and there's just so many people that, it's just, the list goes on and on and on forever. It's incredible. But I wanted to ask Ed, what was one of your most memorable experiences? You helped us, and we received the first award for the show that you produced, right?
Yeah, I think that was our second show, right?
Yeah,
number two.
Yeah.
And that was a show about Professor Larry Leifer, and he was director of the Veterans Administration Rehabilitation Research and Development Department, and we did this show on technology. And Professor Leifer was an unbelievable guest. He was articulate, he was humorous, he was knowledgeable, he was almost a perfect guest. But there was just one problem, as I recall. There was a little bit of a problem communicating between Donna and Dr. Leifer, and Rich after a few minutes, says, wait a minute. And he realized that Dr. Leifer was hard of hearing in one ear. Right. So he switched Donna's and his positions. So she was talking into his good ear, and everything went perfectly.
Right, yeah. What is your first experience of?
Well, the one I remember best and seemed to be more involved than any of the others was the Canine Companions show.
Right.
We went up to Santa Rosa. Mm-hmm. We talked with the director of Canine Companions. Yeah. We were able to contact John Provost, who is the Lassie and Timmy fame. We also had a clip from Charles Schultz, who was a promoter of Canine Companions, and we were able to run that clip.
Well, because he drew Peanuts.
Yes.
Know? Snoopy.
Yes, he did.
That's right.
Yes, he did. And and then we had on that show Jennifer Cuff, who had been in an automobile accident and had gone through the windshield, and she was very severely head injured. Mm-hmm. The reason that show brings back so many memories is because I decided to try to find Jennifer Cuff again after all these years. Right. That was like 25 years ago.
Yeah.
And so I found her, and I've been communicating with her, and we did a follow-up show on her and her partner, Ron. Mm-hmm. Another one that I really liked was the Timpani Center.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember the Timpani Center?
Yes.
The winter dance?
I remember the San Jose State cheerleaders.
Okay, let's go on. But you filmed the people underwater.
Yes.
Yeah, I had a friend who was a scuba diver, and we got him, I don't know how we got it, I think your father Don arranged for it.
Yeah, we rented it.
We got an underwater
camera,
and we showed how the aides at the Timpani Center would bring the people into the pool down a ramp, if they were in wheelchairs, and the exercises they would take them through, and we got both above water and below water. And it was a great show. The people that were in the show loved it. They felt very entertained.
Yeah, exactly, as everyone did. And I want to also mention, Ed, that really we became friends because of my good friend Sally St. Jules.
Yes.
She was my social worker.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Back, I won't say what year, but a couple years back.
Oh, a little while ago, yes.
Yeah, she's like, Ed, he'll help us out.
And you know, she called me to find out if I would be interested in coming down and, you know, operate a studio camera or whatever. And I said, I think I'd be interesting. And my first meeting with Rich, he tried to convince me that On the Move was a show about dietary fiber.
You did.
He did.
Yes, he did. You acquired diabetes.
I don't know the year I acquired it, but 1995 was the year I found out that I had it.
Oh, okay.
Passed out at work, and everyone thought I had a heart attack, and they rushed me to the hospital in an ambulance. And when I got there, they did the test on me, and they said, no, you just had low blood sugar.
Wow.
My blood sugar had dropped to something like 45 or something like that, which is very dangerous.
Oh, my gosh.
And so I went and I saw an endocrinologist, and I got on a routine to take care of it. And so now I've got it under control.
That's
take
amazing.
Insulin every day.
Wow. And you told me that one of your favorite shows was about Adam, our little friend. He was so adorable.
Adam, my hero. He was a 5-year-old boy, and he came on the show with his parents, and he had cystic fibrosis and
cerebral palsy
and two or three other maladies that were debilitating, but he could communicate, and he walked in with a smile as big as Texas, and everything was yes, sir, and thank you, sir, and yes, ma'am, and thank you, ma'am. Yeah. And we did the interview with him, and he never complained about anything, and he talked about how positive he was about life and what he had plans to do and so on and so forth. And when we walked out of that studio that night, I thought to myself, if I hear anybody complain to me, I'm going to smack him in the head. Because here's this kid who's got all these maladies, mm-hmm. and he's got such a positive attitude. Mm-hmm. And then sadly, we heard years right. later that he passed away.
Right, yeah.
Another show that I remember well was we had this lady who's a race car driver who had cystic fibrosis, mm-hmm. and she had a funny story to tell, which was her husband was a race car driver, mm-hmm. and she worked on his crew. She was like a mechanic. And then she started taking the car around for test drives. She became his crew chief, and she'd take the car around for test drives. Well, to make a long story short, it turned out she was a better driver than he was.
No.
So he became the crew chief, and she became the driver.
Oh, my God.
And she would drive in races. And her father created a special helmet for her to wear that would put oxygen into her helmet while she was driving, so that she wouldn't...
To help her to breathe.
Help her to breathe, you know? And I thought that was a great story.
Oh, yeah.
One of the more memorable shows for me, too, was... and I think, I'm not mistaken, I think you guys were still here when we did that show. It was the lady who...
Angelina?
Had been told... No.
Oh, yeah.
The lady who had been told she had MS.
Oh.
And she had all the symptoms of MS, and... somebody told her that sometimes the mercury fillings in your teeth can bring that about.
Right, yeah.
And she'd been going to doctors for mm-hmm. years trying yeah. to get recovery.
Yeah.
And she went into the dentist office mm-hmm. and she sat down and she got up and she walked out of the chair without a wheelchair. Walked wow. for the first time in years
yeah.
and was completely relieved of all her symptoms. And the thing I remember most about the show was not only the wonderful story.
Yeah.
But after the show, she came up to me, and she had been interviewed by 60 Minutes the week before because of her amazing recovery. And she came up to me, she said, "Rich, I just want to compliment you." He says, "Your crew is more professional than they were at CBS." And I just thought, that's great. You know, I felt so proud of our crew at that time. She said I had a much more enjoyable time here with this. So I thought that was great.
That was very nice. Yeah. Very nice.
We did a lot, though.
Yeah.
I mean,
oh,
it was
a
lot of training at De Anza College where we started out.
Right.
But I remember that almost every one of us had to learn every piece of equipment.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And even though we did, we kind of settled into what we were comfortable with.
Right.
Cross-training,
that was important.
Yes, that's right.
And of course, there they were changing equipment every month. Every month we
that's
had to
right.
learn a different
like
field
yeah.
production camp.
Yeah.
Well, the, thing,
yeah.
the thing that we worried about, the thing I worried about the most was that if somebody who was a specialist on a piece of equipment didn't show up one week,
yeah.
you know, nobody else knew how to do it. So the
right.
cross-training was
yeah.
important so that
yeah.
we could be flexible
yeah.
and
right.
equipment.
Critical, yeah. At one point we had over 100 volunteers, you know, that we could actually call on if someone was out of town and we knew they had a specialty, then we were able to call and say, "Can you please help us out?" You know.
What was amazing to me was the amount of disabled people that you had and probably still do mm-hmm. have on your crew.
Right.
I mean, it is by and for the disabled.
And I also wanted to point out that our first On the Move sign was actually written and drawn by David Lowe, mm-hmm. and he did the drawing of it, and then Tim Risch did the actual platform where at the beginning of the show where you see the cameraman kind of teeter tottering and doing a wheelie. Tim designed the circular. It's like a huge Lazy Susan, so that mm-hmm. you know Neil Schnarr would hold the heavy cameras mm-hmm. back then, you know, and he held it as they turned the turntable around to get the perfect angle at the beginning of this.
If I remember correctly, that was your nephew.
A friend of mine's nephew.
Yeah. Friend of yours. Nephew.
Linda's
right.
nephew.
Right.
Yeah. And he did the first posturing for it to see how it would look.
Mm-hmm.
And that was exciting also because it was the development of an organization. And
yeah.
we were in on the ground floor. And we
the logo.
Yeah,
yes,
exactly.
It was.
That's
it
right.
was. It is. You've stylized it and really perfected it a lot. But
you know, as all of us gathered here tonight have acknowledged, I don't think On the Move could have come about without Rich.
Right.
He is riding off into the sunset and certainly has left a legacy
to the disabled
community of Silicon Valley.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate that.
That's so true.
You all know the story of how I got involved with On the Move?
No, they don't know.
I was working at Hewlett Packard, as was Donna.
Yep.
And the first guest we ever had, a guy named Jeff Braille, who's a wheelchair basketball player. Right. And Donna had gotten the permission to have studio time to do this show. Right. And she was trying to find ideas for shows to run. Right. So she asked Jeff, why I don't know, because he doesn't know anything about TV. But she asked Jeff, who I got hired at HP, I hired him.
Right.
But she asked him if he knew anybody who knew anything about television.
Directing.
Now, I had taken some classes at De Anza on acting, just for something to do one night a week. And in the process, I started writing some scripts for us to use and all that. Right. And Jeff knew about that. And they televised some of my scripts at the De Anza days. When they opened up De Anza's TV studio, the first thing they showed was 9 of my scripts live on television. So, you know, that lit off a bulb in Jeff's mind. I said, oh, yeah, I know this guy knows everything there is to know about television. And he tells her about me. So she said, well, could he meet with us? So Jeff calls me up. He says, hey, I got this friend, blah, blah, blah. Could you meet with them and give them some ideas for some shows? So I said, sure, no problem.
So then we went over to LaVonne's house, right?
No. Then I was told to meet Don and some people at the Anza Student Center. And so I get to the Anza Student Center, and there's this room filled with people in wheelchairs, on crutches, blind, you know, the blind leading the blind.
All my college buddies, right?
And I'm looking at all of them, and I asked somebody, I said, what's going on here? He said, oh, they're waiting for the guest speaker. So I'm saying, oh, well, I'm looking for a guy named Don Yeager. Where is he? She says, that's him standing over there. So I walk over and I say, you're Mr. Yeager? He goes, yes, I'm Rich Martinez. I was told to come and see you. I said, but I guess you're waiting for your guest speaker. He goes, that's you. So I got up on the podium and I looked at all these people. And I started asking questions, and it quickly became apparent that the only thing anybody there knew about television was how to turn it on, how to turn it off. And I said, oh boy. So anyway, they said, well, would you take us through some training sessions? And I said, okay. So I took them through some training sessions. And then they said, well, would you take us a little further? So I said, okay, I'll take you through your first real show. I'll help you through there. And then I said, I'll take you through 3 shows. And then I said, you're still not ready. I'll take you through 10 shows. And then I said, well, what the hell? I might as well stay here. I know everybody's name.
I stayed. 360 shows later.
360 shows later. I'm finally breaking away.
How many years? 20.
You finally got it right.
How many years?
25 years.
25. Wow.
25 years. I mean, some people don't stay married that long.
Some people, yeah.
One of them has a few words to say.
Okay. Yeah, if you have a minute, Rich, so I'm here on behalf of the city of Sunnyvale, your home, and it presents you with this certificate from our illustrious mayor, Melinda Hamilton, on behalf of the council and the city. And I'll just read it if you don't mind. I haven't learned my lines yet. The city of Sunnyvale, California congratulates Richard Martinez upon the occasion of his retirement on February 21st, 2011 as Executive Director of On the Move. Having produced, developed, and directed over 250 shows since 1986, and further commends him for his 25 years of outstanding and dedicated service to public access TV that has benefited our community as well as generations of Sunnyvale residents. Signed and sealed this 21st day of February, Linda Hamilton. Thank you. I think the next thing is a speech, probably.
Yeah. Speech. The only thing I can think of to say is you're on the left. It's been a fabulous, glamorous, glorious 25 years. The best friends I have in the world are in this room. And it's like another family for me. Seeing them grow, seeing them develop, seeing them age,
nothing personal.
Gracefully.
Working together, and you know, every time we did a show, as soon as I walked into the studio, the first thing I'd say is, it's amazing. Everybody shows up every show. They're still here. The dedication of the crew was just beyond words. I just couldn't believe it. I mean, people would come and come and come and do it. And we'd go through waves of groups and generations of groups. And we never, never had to not do a show because we didn't have crew.
Right, right.
That never happened. Right. That never happened. That was something I'm very, very proud of, along with the fact that, because we were so sensitive to that our guests were disabled, that in the 25 years we've been doing it, no one has ever been hurt on our set.
Right.
No one has ever been injured. So that's something I'm proud of, too.
Right.
God, you guys, Tim.
I want to thank you very much for your your devotion and your dedication over these many years.
Thank you.
This little celebration tonight is most well deserved.
Thank you.
And we want you to know that. Chan, thank you very much for supporting him during the hours of meditation and whatnot. That I presume that when I dropped by the house, he's sound asleep. He's meditating about the show.
Exactly.
All right. Good. Well, listen. In remembrance of some of these things, we've got a little basket of some things that we'd like you to have to help you keep in mind what really went on here at the studio.
As long as the cops don't find out. Oh, that's nice. Okay. That's very nice.
Oh, is that lovely?
That's beautiful.
Turn it around. Yeah. Let everybody see the whole thing.
There's a picture of me directing, looking at Jeannie and thinking to myself, when is she going to get out of there? There's a picture of me and my little sweetheart, Donna.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I think is there anything more in there? There, here, let me hold this for you.
Chan is on the move.
Very funny.
I think there's one that said Rich is on the move.
Oh, yeah, Rich is on the move.
Matching.
Rich is on the move when Jan tells him to get on the move.
Hold him up there.
Hold him up, Rich.
They're all part of the moving on gang.
Who's directing the show?
I am.
Okay.
When's moving day, Rich?
March the 2nd.
Wow.
Yeah, it's coming up. Anybody who feels the need to work off some stress is cordially invited to come and help us pack.
We're working on the garage.
Well, once again, Rich, I really want to thank you for your years of devotion. And it's like anybody says, if you want to get out of town, then you've got to find and train your replacement, right?
I did. I trained three
of
them.
So we've got three great replacements here coming right in behind you.
That's right.
So now it's only up to you to check them off and say, yes, you're qualified. Now we're in business.
All I can say, Don, is nobody will ever replace you.
You don't expect me to say anything more, do you?
Yeah. Aww. Okay.
So,
boy, I never knew what the guests had to go through in the flights.
Yeah. I don't think all the guests go through this.
No, that's for sure. That's for sure. Okay, so we're going to do a show now?
Yep. Let's get going with the show.
Turp! Turp!
Thank you.
We put a lot of pictures to choose from. It didn't say what kind of a bird.
It worked.
Beautiful. Oh, is that nice or what?
Yeah, those 10 shows really drew. 10 after 10 after 10.
And you know, it's gone so fast. I can't believe it's been 25 years. I mean, it seems like yesterday we were meeting in your house and having a meeting.
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
I remember early meetings in LaVonne's house.
Exactly. That's right.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Well, when we, the crew, we were able to go skiing up at Tahoe, and mm-hmm. let's see, we got to visit Santa Cruz quite a few times, talking about surfing shows and whitewater river rafting shows. Mm-hmm. We have done a lot, as well as educating people about, you know, technology. We have a fun side to On the Move also. we have a little bit of adventure in all of us, I think so. I'm looking at Roxanne when I say that. You know, because we did. We went skiing at the top of Alpine at the summit and went screaming down the hill.
Well, she's still in the opening clip, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. They didn't put me in there because I was screaming too loud. It was that triple gainer, you know, they didn't like that. But anyway, I also want to talk about, I want to say the phone number for the Diabetes Association in case people want to, you know, call to receive more information. It's really easy. It's just 800-DIABETES. And then you also had heart problems as well, and I want to put that phone number in here too, 650-565-8482. So, you know, people can refer to those numbers and find out more information.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you were incredible. You came, you know, like 2 days, 3 days after surgery when you weren't supposed to come. But you're like, no, I have to go. I have to make sure the show is okay. So you are the epitome of On the Move. I want to say one other quick thing about how important John Kearney was to us. He actually, I met him at church, and you know, I just heard this amazing voice, and I asked him if he would consider, you know, helping us do the narration with On the Move, and he said, "My pleasure." You know, but John would come every show at the beginning of the show and ride up on his motorcycle and, you know, do that one take John and do the narration. And, you know, he kind of, you know, talked with the guests and, you know, made everyone feel comfortable with that big smile of his. And you know, then he would ride off into the sunset on his motorcycle, and he was very involved with square dancing.
He used to call the dancers.
Yeah, right. So that's why he wasn't able to stay for the whole show. He had other places to go. He was on the move.
Hello and welcome to On the Move. Nowadays, when you have a brain attack or a stroke, the chances of survival have greatly improved. One of the downsides of recovering from a stroke is the possibility that your capabilities can be compromised. On the Move visited the Santa Clara Resource Fair, where we met Rezvan McAdam from the Peninsula Stroke Association located in Palo Alto, California. The PSA delivers its life-saving message about stroke through lectures, community events, and health fairs. We also met stroke survivor Mike Cooper, who had a stroke and lost his ability to speak. Mike and his wife, helper, and caregiver, Mika, join us in the studio. They share with us the program they employ that helped Mike regain his ability to talk. He is recovering from his condition called apraxia, that is the result of damage to his cerebrum caused by the stroke. Now here is our On the Move host, Donna Yeager,